हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम राघवेंद्र कुमार सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ यूएस एकेडमी एंड इंस्टीट्यूट। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस क्लास 8, ज्योग्राफी सेकेंड चैप्टर, लैंड, सॉइल, वाटर, नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ रिसोर्सेज। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑब्जर्व द लैंड type of soils and water availability in the region you live. See how it has influenced the lifestyle of the peoples there. 90% of the world population occupies only 30% of the land area. The remaining 70% of the land area is either sparsely populated or uninhabited. To know about these topics, we have to discuss the chapter Land, Soil, Water, Natural Resources, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife Resources. In this chapter, we have to understand about the lands. A very important natural resource, land covers 30% of the earth's surface and not every part is inhabitable. Caused from the uneven population in certain parts, which varied characteristics of land and climate. Areas that are sparsely populated or uninhabited, densely populated areas, rugged topography, steep slopes of the mountains, low-lying areas susceptible to water, plain river valleys. Land are usually important because it provides most of the human needs. Its use depends on physical factors such as topography, soil, climatic condition, availability of water. Due to the excessive use of land for agriculture and constructional activities, the major problems of land degradation, landslide, soil erosion, etc. arises. To conserve the land, we must promote afforestation, check to overgraze and regulate the use of chemical pesticides and fertilizers. These are lands suitable for the agriculture, means the uses of land. The land is used for different purposes such as to define the agricultural forestry, mining, building houses, roads and setups of industries is commonly termed as land use. Most of the factors which are physical has to determine the use of land: topography, soil, texture, minerals and availability of water. Human factors that are human determinants of land use pattern, population and technology. Land can also be classified into private lands and community lands. To the basis of ownership, private land owned by individual person, whereas community land is owned by the community. For common uses such as the collection of fodder, fruits, nuts and medicinal herbs. Other name for communal lands is common property resources. Even though people demands are ever growing, availability of land in limited, thus leading peoples to encroach lands to build commercial areas such as shopping complexes in urban areas and to expand agricultural lands in rural areas. This expansion of agricultural and constructional activities also leads to major threats like land degradation, landslides, soil erosion, and desertification. Now, the conservation of land resources. Ever-growing population and their growing demands leads to large-scale destruction of forest covers and other natural resources. Meanwhile, given below as the common method used for conservation of land resources. Number 1, afforestation. Number 2, land reclamation. Number 3, regulated use of chemical pesticides. And number 4, fertilizers check on overgrazing. Now, what about the soil? This thin layer of grainy substances covering the land of the earth and closely linked to the land. Landforms determine the types of soil. Soil is made up of organic matter, minerals and weathered rock found on the earth through the processes of weathering. The right mix of minerals and organic matters make the soil fertile. Landslides. The mass movement of rocks, debris or earth down a slope is known as landslides, and it often takes place in conjunction with earthquakes. Flood and volcanoes, meanwhile, a prolonged spell of rainfall can also cause a landslide. Mitigation mechanism, which developed in scientific techniques, has empowered us to understand what factors cause landslides and how to manage them. Some of the broad mitigation techniques of landslides are given. Hazard mapping to locate area prone to landslide. Hence, such areas can be avoided for buildings and settlements. Construction of retention walls to stop the land from slipping areas. In the vegetation covers to arrest landslides, the surface drainage controls works to control the movement of a landslide along with rainwater and spring flow. Now the factor affecting the soil formation. The nature of the parent rock, climate factor, topography, role of organic matters, time taken for the composition of soil formation. Degradation of soil and conservation measures. Soil erosion and depletion are the major threats to the soil as a resource. Both human and natural factors can lead to degradation of soil. Factors which lead to soil degradation are deforestation, overgrazing, overuse of chemical fertilizers or pesticides, rain wash, landslides and floods. Meanwhile, some methods of the soil conservation are mulching. The bare ground between plant is covered with a layer of organic matter like straw, and it helps to retain soil moisture. Counter barriers, stones, grass, soil use to build barriers along counter. Trenches are made in front of the barriers to collect water. Rock dams. Rocks are piled up to slow down the flow of water and also helps to prevent gullies and further soil loss. Terrace farming. Broad flat slabs or terraces are made on the steep slopes so that flat surfaces are available to grow crops, thus reducing surfaces, runoff and soil erosion. Intercropping. Different crops are grown in alternate rows and are sown at different times to protect the soil from rain wash. Counter plowing. counterplying parallel to the counter of a hill slopes to form a natural barriers for water to flow down the slopes. Shelter belts. In the coastal areas and dry regions, row of trees are planted to check the wind movement to protect soil cover. Now the water. 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with a vital renewable natural resource known as water. Ocean covers about 2/3 of the earth's surface and supports a rich variety of plants and animal life. However, it is saline and not useful for human consumption. Fresh water accounts for only 2.7%, and 70% of these occurs as ice sheets and glaciers in Antarctica, Greenlands, and mountain regions. And they are inaccessible because of their location. Thus, only 1% of fresh water is useful for human consumption. Water can neither be added nor subtracted from the earth, and its total volume remain constant. Its abundance seems to vary only because of the constant motion. Cycling through the ocean, the air, the land, and back again. Through the process of evaporation, precipitation, and runoff. This, as you already know, is referred to as the water cycle. Now the problem of water availability. Most part of the world are facing shortages in the fresh water supply. Countries located in climatic zone most susceptible to drought face great problems of water scarcity. Thus, water shortage may be a consequence of variation in seasonal or annual precipitation, or the scarcity is caused by over-exploitation and contamination of water sources. Now the conservation of water resources. To get access of clean and adequate water source, steps have been taken to preserve these resources. Forest and other vegetation cover slow the surface runoff and replenish underground water. Water harvesting is another method to save the water runoff. The canals used for irrigation field should be properly lined to minimize losses by water seepage. Sprinkler effectively irrigate the area by checking water losses. Through seepage and evaporation in a dry region with high rates of evaporation, drip or trickle irrigation is very useful. The valuable water resource can, therefore, be conserved by adopting these means of irrigation. Natural vegetation and wildlife. Natural vegetation and wildlife exist in the narrow zone of contact between the lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere that we call the biosphere. In the biosphere, living beings are interrelated and interdependent on each other for survival. This life-supporting system is known as ecosystem. Wildlife includes animals, birds, insects, as well as the aquatic life forms. The birds feed on insects and act as decomposer as well. Vultures, due to its ability to feed on dead livestock, is a scavenger and considered a vital cleanser of the environment. So animals, big or small, all are integral to maintaining balance in the ecosystem. Now the distribution of natural vegetation. The growth of vegetation depends primarily on temperature and moisture. The major vegetation types of the world are grouped as forest, grasslands, scrubs, and tundra. In areas of heavy rainfall, huge trees thrive. Forests are thus associated with area having abundant water supply. As the number of moisture decreases, the size of trees and their density reduces. Short stunted trees are shrubs, and shrubs grown in region of moderate rainfall. In dry areas, thorny shrubs and scrubs grow in low rainfall areas. Now the conservation of natural wildlife and vegetation. Changes in climatic and human interference can cause the loss of natural habitat for the plants and animals. Deforestation, soil erosion, constructional activities, forest fires, tsunami, and landslides are some of the human and natural factors that accelerate the process of extinction of their resources. One other major concern is the poaching that results in sharp decline in the number of particular species. National parks, wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserves are much to protect our natural vegetation and wildlife. Conservation of creeks, lakes, and wetlands is necessary to save the precious resource for depletion. Awareness program like social forestry and Van Mahotsav are also established to the regional and community level. School children are also encouraged to bird watch and visit nature camps so that they appreciate the habitat of varied species. Many countries have passed laws against the trade as well as the killing of birds and animals. In India, killing lions, tigers, deer, great Indian bustard and peacock is illegal. Meanwhile, an international convention, CITES, has been established that lists several species of animals and birds in which trade is prohibited. These are huge concerns about the conservation of the important resources. We must contribute to this. Nature parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves are ways to protect vegetation and wildlife. Conservation of plant and animal is a moral duty of every human beings.